I think sport has always been about learning. I've been very fortunate to have good coaches when I was growing up. I also was fortunate to actually be taken into the wings of two Chinese coaches whom I worked during, one during the early part of my career, Wong Shaomin, and one during my stay in Germany playing for a club league. Those along with my other coaches who were there, and my exposure to various centers across the world, across the country, actually ensured that I had a lot of things which I learned. Many of the things I learned also from trial and error. So by the end of my career, when I started to win, when things looked good, I kind of realized that this was the formula to win and this is what is needed to win. But unfortunately, I couldn't use it too much on myself because I got injured. I had multiple surgeries on my knees and had a lot of problems on my foot. And in the transition between playing and resting, I almost drove me to coaching because I thought I knew something which could be useful for the juniors and I should use it. Intensity of work, quality work, is what matters. I think if you want to be good, you need to train at that level which you aspire to, and it needs to be consistent. The other factor is that you cannot only train 4 hours or 5 hours or 6 hours and let the rest of the day turn out and do things which are opposite to what is needed to be a top player. So it's important that your life also is streamlined in such a way that you kind of are focused totally, not only in the time when you're playing, but when you're outside as well. So you're resting well, you're eating properly, you're disciplined in your thoughts, and then you practice hard. I think this, over time, leads to good results. Today we have huge numbers participating in the sport at various levels, and we have great infrastructure as well coming up at various corners of the city and the country, and all we need to do is put it into a system so that we are able to identify and nurture talent for the future. Across the board, we've had some good results. Sattvic Chirag reaching the finals of France was a good result. They winning Thailand was a good result. And then size medals and size good performance in the men's singles, and Sindhu doing particularly well at the World Championships. These, I think, would be the highlights for this season. But at the end of the year, I think we have about 5 players in the top 25 of the world. Almost trying their best to be part of the Olympics. If you take the last 3 Olympics from 2008, 12, 16, I think we got to the first quarterfinals in Beijing. In 2012, we had in London a bronze. In 2016 in Rio, we've had a silver. Hopefully we can close the circle and have a gold in Tokyo is what I do believe. But I also do believe that our doubles teams and the men's singles have a chance as well. And if things go well, God willing, in August next year, hopefully we'll have another medal from the other events as well.